calibrating the zero and span of any Mensor standalone transducer or a transducer that is used inside an instrument will require the Mensor Calibration Utility software, the transducer to be calibrated, a Windows PC, a pressure source, a pressure standard, the combined power and communication cables for the standalone transducers, or a calibration sled for those transducers that are a component of a Mensor pressure controller or indicator. For absolute transducers below 170 PSIA, a vacuum gauge standard and a vacuum pump will be necessary. For an absolute transducer above 170 PSIA, a precision barometer will be needed. The Calibration Utility software is available at Mensor.com in the Service Calibration section of the website under Download Software, PC Software. The Calibration Utility software package can be downloaded as a zip file. And contains all necessary files to set up and run the program, a user manual, and the Microsoft.NET framework file. The Microsoft.NET framework 4.0 or greater must be installed. To install the Calibration Utility software, run the setup program. The setup program installs all the necessary files for the utility. It will register all files appropriately so that it can be completely removed using the Windows Add Remove program. Upon installation, a desktop shortcut and a start menu shortcut will be added. Otherwise, the transducer utility program may be run directly. The computer must have a serial port capable of running at 57600 baud. An adapter can be used to convert to a USB connection. The calibration software is capable of communication with all Mensor transducers currently in production. However, each transducer has a specific calibration sled or cable used for power and communication. All varieties of sleds and cables are shown in the transducer utility manual. For a transducer that uses a calibration sled, connect the AC adapter of the power supply to an AC power socket. Then, connect the power supply to the circular power connector on the rear of the calibration sled. Connect the 9-pin D-sub connector on the calibration sled to any available serial port on the computer, using an adapter if needed. For a standalone transducer, connect the AC adapter to an AC power socket. Then, connect the computer side of the cable to any available serial port on the computer using an adapter if needed. Connect the transducer side of the cable to the transducer. After all connections are made, open the utility software and check to see if the transducer is communicating. The program will automatically find all available serial COM ports. Select the serial COM port connected to the transducer and the appropriate baud rate. The default baud rate is 57600 baud. Next, select the type of transducer to read. You may also use the auto detect option. The COM test button will perform a quick communication check and display the transducer found. To calibrate a transducer, click the Calibrate icon at the bottom of the window. The program will take a few seconds to retrieve all the information from the transducer to be displayed. This initial screen of the transducer calibration software provides an interface to read and write to the transducer. The software automatically updates fields read from the transducer. The manual that is part of the downloaded zip file provides a complete explanation of these fields and buttons that appear on the screen. In addition, there is an explanation of how to linearize specific transducers with that capability and a data logging feature. This video will focus on how to calibrate the zero and span of a 500 PSI CPT-9000 absolute transducer. If points in between zero and span are required, refer to the linearization correction section of the manual. Absolute ranges above 170 PSIA can be zeroed at atmospheric pressure using a precision barometer with an accuracy of 0.01% of reading. Ranges below 170 should be zeroed close to 600 millitorr using a precision vacuum standard. Alternatively, a gauge transducer can be easily zeroed by venting the pressure and reference ports to ambient pressure. After the electrical connections have been made, connect the pneumatic connections. Because we are calibrating a 500 PSIA transducer, we can zero the transducer at atmospheric pressure using a precision barometer and a deadweight tester to pressurize and measure the full-scale value. A typical pneumatic setup is shown in the diagram. Connect the components of the system as shown and open the Calibration Utility software. For this example, load the weights that will create a pressure close to 500 PSIA. Best practice prescribes that the transducer be exercised by running it from the minimum range to full scale at least 2 times, dwelling at each extreme for 2 to 3 minutes. Begin the calibration with the pressure vented to atmospheric pressure. When a stable zero point is reached, compare the reading with the precision barometer. Record both values if as found data is needed. Click the 2-point calibration button on the utility software and enter the value from the barometer. Now, apply 500 PSIA using the deadweight tester. After the pressure has stabilized, compare the reading with the pressure being generated by the deadweight tester and record if as found data is needed. Type the pressure applied by the deadweight tester and press the enter button. This sets the span value. Reduce the pressure back to the zero point and check it again. If it is out of tolerance, click the zero button, enter the reading from the barometer, then recheck the span to make sure it is in tolerance. Use the span button to make adjustment at span if needed. If all readings are in tolerance, you are done.